decisions about healthcare are not necessarily made by ministers of health, but made by all sorts of people. And really, the message is, again, consider the importance of health to minimize the necessity for healthcare. And the architects, planners, landscape architects, have a very significant role to play in actually making healthy communities.
The World Health Organization estimates that 350 million people have diabetes worldwide. And in developing countries, the rise in diabetes has actually been linked quite closely to shifts in urbanization. But this is data from Toronto, and on the top are recent immigrants, and on the bottom, people who have been longer-term residents, so living in Canada, living in Ontario for more than 10 years in Canada. And what you can see is compared to people living in the least walkable area had over a 50% higher risk of developing diabetes over 5 years. Changes in zoning, urban planning and design that promotes walking and other forms of active transportation may help to curb the ongoing rise in obesity and diabetes.
And there is a story to tell, I think, about the role that cities and city builders play in shaping the health of the populations of those cities. And that includes planners and engineers and architects. If you took a look at the population of the city of Toronto about a century ago, these would be more or less the leading causes of death. And it's one way of measuring what the big health challenges are in the population, is looking at what we die of. We used to think, back in the mid-20th century, that it was really all about medical technology, and that it was the vaccines and antibiotics that had vanquished the major communicable disease threats. But in fact, if you look at the timelines, it didn't happen that way. We treated our drinking water differently, we treated our sewage differently, we created better housing, and all of those things created conditions which led to much lower rates of transmission of communicable diseases. So, it turned out that these were not really diseases of bugs, these were diseases of how we were living at the time.
In 2003, there was a special issue of the American Journal of Public Health devoted to health and the built environment. It was the first time that the medical community and the public health community got together with landscape architects, and urban planners together. And a joint issue. And there have been books that have been written by physicians that talk about the planning components of suburbia and so on, and how they. But where have the architects been in all this? The architects haven't really been a meaningful part of the discourse. So I think we need to do a lot more than we're doing in our daily practice and in our interactions with our colleagues in other disciplines and with our clients. So I'll end it at that.